The asteroids are classified into different types or classes based on their reflectance spectra, which are obtained using terrestrial telescopes. Now, these different types are not homogeneously distributed throughout the asteroid belt. Rather, there are some different abundances of these types cluster at different distances. And this is what is shown here on this plot. So on the x-axis, there's the distance of the asteroids from the Sun in astronomical units. So Earth would be here at 1. And they cluster around somewhere between something like 2 and 3.23 or so astronomical units. On the y-axis here is the frequency. So this means this is just the abundance in parts of 100 or 1. This is why there's no specific unit. And then there are the five abundant asteroid types shown here. There are a couple more. And the S-type asteroid, which is the blue one here, is commonly associated with the ordinary chondrites. And the C-type asteroids are often associated with the carbonaceous chondrites. So this would be the yellow one here. And as can be seen, in particular the C-type asteroids, they have a peak at about 2.7 astronomical units, but also a smaller one here and here. And the S-type asteroids have peak also at about 2.7, but also at something like 2.2. But the V-type asteroids have only one peak, or there are some Q types here which have a very broad peak, so they are more distributed throughout the entire asteroid belt. Now, this is an observation that is not yet fully understood, and one might expect rather some more heterogeneous distributions, but it's important to know there is this kind of differences among the various asteroid classes, which we still need to better understand and explain.